there were quite honestly a couple of things that I could have titled this video, anywhere from why Battlefield 5 is so divisive to why Battlefield is declining, but I settled on a more futuristic oriented title in The Future of Battlefield and Why It Is Bleak. One of the questions I get asked most is, Catalyst, why aren't you more positive in your videos about the game, and why don't you look at all the positives instead of always resorting to looking at the negatives? And I suppose I haven't really addressed that question properly up until now. The honest truth is that it's hard to be positive about a game that has been surrounded by negativity from the first second of their reveal trailer, but what's more than that, because I play at a higher level than most players, I see the game in vastly different ways than most players do. Being a competitive player has its advantages, sure, but one thing that it is a clear negative is that I don't see things as purely good or bad. Competitiveness makes you extremely analytical and oftentimes critical of things that, to a majority of players, are black and white issues. And more often than not, when I do get analytical about Battlefield 5, my thoughts and comments on the game are not flattering at all. Does it mean that I hate the game? Not always. I think there is still a good game somewhere underneath the unfinished product that we were given, but it definitely raises questions to me not only about the future of the game, but the future of the franchise as a whole. This past week, Jack Frags released a video talking about the franchise as a whole, where it's been, and where it may go in the future, and it really got me thinking, how did we get to this point? The community is divided, the game is buggy and unfinished, nobody seems to really be happy about it, and for the most part, the trust between the player base and the developers have been severely shaken. And to be clear, I am severely worried about the future of the franchise, because at the bottom of everything, the problem with Battlefield currently isn't something that you can patch out, and it isn't something that can be fixed with more development time, although that would fix a lot. It's unfortunately something entirely different. A lot of people point to the infamous reveal trailer as the beginning of the end for the franchise, for those who think that the end is near, but in my opinion, the cause of the now toxic negativity that surrounds the game actually began somewhere else. It began with Battlefield 1. Now, hear me out on all this, some of you may completely disagree with me, and that's okay, but as somebody who has been around for a long time and has seen the franchise at its highest peaks and now its lowest valleys, it's not that hard to see where everything took a wrong turn. Let's take a trip all the way back to spring of 2016, where two major events happened in the world of FPS games. The first of which being the announcement of Call of Duty Infinite Warfare, which quickly became one of the most disliked videos on YouTube, and the announcement of Battlefield 1, which reversely became one of the most liked videos on YouTube. So why are these two reveal trailers so important? Well, this was the point in time where the current underlying issue of the Battlefield franchise began, the fragmentation of the Battlefield community. Now, hear me out here, because this might not exactly be what you think, because typically when we talk about fragmenting the Battlefield community, we talk about how the season pass divided the player base between haves and haves not, and it ended up killing the game faster than if there was no season pass at all. I'm talking about a different type of fragmenting of the community, one that occurred when Battlefield committed to being casual. To be clear, Battlefield has always been a casual game. It's never been as hardcore as something like CSGO or Rainbow Six Siege, and it never will be. But what I can say is what many Battlefield veterans might agree with, is that prior to Battlefield 1, Battlefield was a game that was not only more difficult, but much more in-depth and complicated than its competitor in Call of Duty, and that fact was something that scared off a lot of casual gamers away from the franchise. The community of past Battlefield titles were generally very knowledgeable about the game, and in turn, despite being an extremely accessible franchise, the game received a reputation of being one that was more hardcore than others. That all changed when both Call of Duty Infinite Warfare and Battlefield 1 was announced. When Call of Duty Infinite Warfare was announced, the gaming community as a whole turned its back on the franchise because they were sick of the game set in futuristic settings and jump packs, and there was a gigantic opening now available in the first-person shooter market that Battlefield was about to consume. Players were looking for a new FPS game to play while Call of Duty went through its rough times with Infinite Warfare. Now, seeing all of this unfold a couple of years later, somewhere along the road, DICE and EA made a collective choice to cater and draw in massive amounts of these players with their brand new title, Battlefield 1, and by all intents and purposes, they got what they wanted. Battlefield 1 was extremely successful financially and commercially, and it did bring in a lot of new yet inexperienced players to the franchise, but underneath everything, the result was a game that was not quite what the hardened, veteran Battlefield community expected or wanted. Now, some of you must be thinking, well, Catalyst, there is no way that DICE and EA knew that Infinite Warfare was going to take off the FPS gaming world, and the answer to that is that they didn't know it. I'd like to think that Battlefield 1 was going to launch with the same mechanics that it did, regardless of whether or not Call of Duty Infinite Warfare flopped or not. Battlefield 1 was going to be a more casual game. The community probably would not have liked it, and I'd like to think that DICE and EA would have reverted back to the award-winning formula for Battlefield games in the first place, since Battlefield has always been kind of the workhorse title for EA, but that's not what happened, and a lot of the post-launch decisions are what catapulted Battlefield into a casual gaming realm of which I don't think it can recover from. They released the now infamous reveal trailer that damaged the game's reputation before it even got a chance to get off the ground, relying on content creators and streamers like myself to save their marketing campaign, even though, as it turned out, they were hell-bent on ruining their marketing anyways with stunts like the famed launch celebration dinner in which they mocked a bunch of angry comments on the game with hashtag everyone's battlefield. In the context of this video, I think that the saying hashtag everyone's battlefield meant a lot more under the surface than people realized back then. Of course, the game, as everybody knows, needed more time to be completed, and it released in a playable but almost anemic state. Promises of content that came pre-launch, such as the competitive game mode Incursions, which featured at the end of Battlefield 1's lifecycle, were not in the game and nowhere to be found. Firestorm, which was one of the game's major selling points, was coming out 4 months later, and the game was filled with other white lies and glitches, and some of the worst netcode that I've seen in a Battlefield game to date. Of course, besides the launch of Battlefield 4. Mechanically speaking, DICE implemented the attrition system, which was a more hardcore mechanic that limited your health and your ammo, a mechanic that I admittedly love, and on paper, is supposed to work quite well. This mechanic was most definitely geared towards the veteran players that were turned off of Battlefield 1's casual gameplay. The only problem is that the casuals have not taken to the system quite as well. The advanced difficulty of Battlefield 5 in comparison to the Battlefield 1 experience that they joined the franchise with was something that they were either not happy about or have not adapted very well to. These are the players that I imagine are the ones we find hiding in corners, scared for their lives. The fast time to kill and the attrition system are the two main things that I think Battlefield 1 players point to when they say that they don't like Battlefield 5. Yet reversely, older players love these changes, but the majority of the community playing right now is more than likely the same casual player base that played Battlefield 1. And to clarify, when I say the term casual player base, that's not intended in any insulting manner, that's just how I'm differing between the two divided player bases. Do y'all see the point I'm getting at here though? There is this divide within the community on what they prefer in their Battlefield game, because DICE and EA went to great lengths to reel in a large chunk of new FPS community players with Battlefield 1, and since they've done that, they've tried to tie both player bases together, and it just hasn't worked how they thought it would. The two player bases are clashing, and nobody really likes the game, especially because DICE has spent more time fixing the game instead of making new content for it. This is something that I predicted months ago after the open beta ended. I said that people were not going to react to the attrition system well because DICE is trying to fit a square box into a circular hole. In implementing a gameplay mechanic that is meant for a hardcore audience, even though the player base is mostly casual. The players that are playing the game currently don't appear to be the same players that played the franchise in the quote-unquote glory days of Battlefield Bad Company 2, Battlefield 3, and Battlefield 4. They are almost always the casual players of Battlefield 1, and they don't appear to be adapting to the game well at all. Gone are the days when people would throw out health and ammo at will to support the team. Now I feel like I need to sacrifice a goat to the Battlefield gods in order for a teammate to throw me a health pack when I'm doing a choreographed dance routine in front of them to get their attention. Not to mention that I don't see anybody using the ping system that was put into the game to replace the spotting system that was quite frankly overpowered in Battlefield 1, even though granted it doesn't always work in Battlefield 5. In larger conquest type game modes, like I guess Conquest, I see people running around to the same flag instead of spreading out and defending the flags we already own. It just lacks common sense sometimes. And of course the visibility issues don't really help anything either. That's one quarter an actual problem, one quarter from people not being able to react to reduced spotting, and one quarter an exploit of the game. Furthermore, I think DICE really doesn't know what they're doing when it comes to the balancing and the vision of what they want the game to be. Just recently, there was a nerf to the SMGs and the full auto assault rifles, changing around their damage and recoil a little bit. What the developers don't recognize, or perhaps they do and just don't care, is that this also serves as an indirect buff to DMRs, which were already by far and away not only the most popular weapons in the game, but the strongest ones too. The developers appear to be winging it sometimes. The content that we are given through the Tides of War are being leaked to us through a rusty pipe, and the game is still lacking some essential components like platoon emblems, rank increases, and most importantly, reasons to play the game. So, where do we sit now? Battlefield 5 sits in turmoil, with no clear direction, and a revolving door of issues. The netcode that at one point seemed to be fixed has now returned to one-frame deaths, incorrect damage registration, lack of hit markers, and a bug that doesn't fully kill you but keeps you stuck on the ground in the bleed-out state, or, I guess, alive on the ground. The game is starving for content, real content, and it seems like the two player bases are now either playing Battlefield 4 or Battlefield 1 again, because as I said earlier, in trying to appease both parties, DICE has created a bit of a messy game that one side seems to truly enjoy enough without this lack of content and compatibility. The next game in the franchise is rumored to be Battlefield Bad Company 3, and DICE and EA have a serious decision to make. If they try to take the middle ground and launch a game that is not finished like they did with Battlefield 5, then the franchise will die off. But if they choose a direction and stick to it, and return to putting love into their games instead of politics, then the franchise might survive. Ladies and gentlemen, thank you so much for watching the video. This took me a couple days to make, so I really appreciate a like on it if you enjoyed it. If you're new here, subscribe for some awesome Battlefield 5 content. A lot of my content isn't like this, mostly gameplays, tips and tricks, guides, and all that jazz. So if you enjoy that kind of stuff, a subscription would truly be appreciated. If you have already subscribed, please make sure you turn on the post notifications and leave a comment down in the comment section. Do you agree with what I said? Do you think that this franchise can be saved, or do you think that it's going down a direction that it cannot recover from? Either way, I'm really interested in seeing what you all think. Thank you all so much for watching. My name is Nick, or Catalyst, and I will see you all another time.